In this demonstration, we'll discuss the importance of setting the correct route map to your DITA Maps hierarchy. For instance, processing key references requires that oxygen determines the effective binding of a given key to a resource in the context of a given route map. Since a route map defines the set of effective key bindings, this process is known as establishing a key space. To correctly reflect the DITA rules for key definitions, Oxygen builds the key space starting from a route map. As a practical example, we'll work with a DITA map structure composed of a route map that references two submaps. In our sample project, both the flowers map and the flowers by family submap define different keys. When the flowers map is set as a route map, Oxygen constructs the key space by collecting keys from the entire map structure. Since documentation projects can often produce huge DITA map structures, with a DITA map that refers many other submaps, you might want to focus on one specific submap at a time. To highlight the benefits of selecting the correct route map, we'll begin our demonstration by working with the Flowers by Season submap as an independent map. As you can see, the DITA Maps Manager view marks the two referred submaps with special icons. When we open the first submap, we notice an error. The problem is that the definition of a key is not found. Furthermore, if we open one of the topics, for example, chrysanthemum, and try to validate it, Oxygen reports that the definition of two of the keys used in the topic are not found. The first warning reports that the link that uses a key reference cannot be resolved because the key definition is not found. The second warning has the same cause, but this time we have a broken content key reference. Also, if we want to insert a key reference, we can see that Oxygen does not find any key definition. See that the key definition table is empty. The problem is that the map is isolated from the rest of the map structure. Note that the route map selector is set to current map, and therefore Oxygen considers that the route map is flowers by season. You can change the route map from the DITA Maps Manager view, or by clicking one of the key reference errors, or from one of the Insert Link dialog boxes. You can see that Oxygen has now collected the key definitions. Note that the route map selector was updated to flowers.DITAMap. From now on, we can use the key definitions in any of the maps within the map structure. If we validate the topic again, Oxygen won't report any problems. Also, the content reference was solved, and now it is displayed correctly. The route map also defines the scope of the rename operation. For example, our map structure references the chrysanthemum topic twice, once in the flowers by season map, and once in the flowers by family map. So, if we want to rename the chrysanthemum file, we should be aware that all of its references need to be updated correctly. To see how it works, we'll switch the route map back to current map, meaning that Oxygen will consider flowers by season to be the route map, thus detaching it from the map's structure. Now, Oxygen narrows the scope of the rename operation to the flowers by season submap only. If we try to rename the chrysanthemum topic file, we see that Oxygen finds only one reference. But if we set the route map to flowers.DITAMap, the scope of the rename operation will be the entire map structure. If we try to rename the file again, Oxygen detects the chrysanthemum topic in both submaps. And this concludes our demonstration. Thank you for watching.